if you're not being honest with a person about their work, what good are you doing them? You know, a lot of people talk about inspiration. Inspiration comes from doing, comes from work, comes from hard work. I get inspired by anything and everything in life, you know, everything I look at every day. I get inspired walking through the woods, you know, observing nature. You know, I'm passionate about life itself, and I think that's where inspiration really comes. Peter Galasso, I paint non-objective art. Also a musician, I'm an artist. After many years, I'm talking maybe 30 years, I started to realize what my voice was. You have to put in those hours before you realize who you are and what you can do. I like to think of the painting as kind of like a human being. In the beginning, you're a baby, you're a toddler, you turn into a teenager, and I don't think too much about what's happening until the very final stages. All painting is made up of layers, repetition. Layers being so important because when you walk through life, everything you see is made up of layers. I still look at the masters, I look at a lot of people I admire, and I get out as much as I can to look at other people's work. I want to see what they're doing. You know, you have to look at stuff. This is one of the early stages of this painting. I'm going to cover the whole thing with a glaze and then I'm going to wipe it off. But everything, all the glaze that remains in the grooves and the gouges, that's going to stay. Again, just adding more to the history of the painting. Paintings are like a time capsule too. You know, it's a moment in time of the person who created it. Robert Henri, the ashcan artist and teacher in Manhattan back in the 20s and 30s, he said, "We are not here to do what has already been done." That's etched into my heart. I think where and how you grow up has a lot to do with it. I come from a broken home. There was a lot of trauma. I hate to say this, but I think most great artists come from a bad place like that, some kind of trauma. The world is nasty, life is not fair, life beats the hell out of all of us. If you get through it though, if you just stick to knowing that you have a right to be here, you'll begin to blossom, you know, and find out what your usefulness is. This is a stool that my grandfather made. I would visit him with my family. I would sit on this. This would be my own seat. It's the only thing I have from my grandfather. I use it once in a while when I want to get up on a big painting, get a little higher. Let me show you what my grandmother used to make. She used to make these doilies, and from what I understand, she made bigger things too, like bedspreads. It's unsymmetrical, you know, and uneven. It's wabi-sabi. It's imperfect. At the same time, it's beautiful. You know, every once in a while I'm painting, I'll put something in there that's representative. Like there's kind of a woman's shape in there. And sometimes I eradicate it, but sometimes I just go with it.
This is the early stage of these ones.
Yeah, all kinds of mark making, sometimes throwing paint at it. This one I threw some paint on and then I moved it around with a like a rubber squeegee. My daughter asks me, "How do you know when the painting is finished?" And I tell her, when I think I've had enough of it, I hang it up and I look at it every day. And if I can look at it every day and still something about it surprises me, it's done, you know? Just, you know, study what has come before and practice your art. Get in there and work. And when I say work, I mean work. You know, work hard. Don't be satisfied by the first few brush strokes that you lay down. Keep at it, keep at it, keep going over it. Throw them away if they're no good or paint over them, but just keep working. You know, everything comes from experience. You got to put in the hours.